The Earth is getting smaller and more interconnected decade by decade. 100 years ago, it would have taken someone on the West Coast 2 weeks to get to Germany. I got there in about a day. But let's go some steps further and ask, what if the whole Earth functioned as a single city? First, we would have to be a bit loose with our definition of a city. Cities are dense urban areas often surrounded by suburban zones, but we're going to have to take a different approach, as we will not be urbanizing the whole of the Earth, but interconnecting it to a degree that one could essentially commute between, for example, Spain and India. First, we will assume that all of Earth is united under one government, or a union of like-minded governments, similar to the European Union. This will make it way easier to go between different modern-day countries without having to wait for hours at the border control every single border. This pretty clearly also needs to be a good couple of centuries in the future for maglev and or hyperloop technology to improve and be readily available enough to build that metro system. With a system like this, assuming a top speed of 1200 kilometers an hour, a trip from Portland to Berlin could take a few hours. The Earth being very big, along with the fact that there would still be independent, unmerged cities dotting the globe, means that Earth wouldn't be a true city, but at most perhaps a major metropolitan area. Perhaps a better example is a small, interconnected country, like Germany. Going between Berlin and Frankfurt on mine is pretty easy and quick, but still takes around 4 to 5 hours in the ICE. But it's still downright reasonable. Let's not get too unambitious though. After all, this is an imaginary scenario for hundreds of years in the future. With that in mind, how would this planetary mega-metropolis function? First, this would be globalization at the biggest level we could imagine, and could put a new perspective on many things, like time zones. Even if we adopted a universal time, it would be difficult to adapt to a new time zone so quickly, which I imagine would involve creative ways to cheat the system, like CGB graying it and not adapting at all. I doubt people would be commuting to the other side of the world, though. Rather, they would probably commute to the other side of their continent and occasionally jaunt over to the other side of the world, like commuting around the Berlin-Brandenburg area and occasionally taking a train to the other side of Germany or to a neighboring country. Cars could also be useful, but probably not our modern cars, though people would probably stay within their own city. One could also, say, easily sort the seasons. If you're too cold, all you need to do is spend a few hours on the metro and go to a different hemisphere and you're there.
The next station is Brisbane. Doors to my left.
Obviously, tourism would probably skyrocket, but probably only at first, with it steadily dying down. Perhaps a trip to a faraway land might be a little less appealing knowing you could go on a weekend, like me taking a trip to Seattle. This, however, would still be great for business, and hotels would obviously still be in use. Though this would probably be a time when physically being somewhere doesn't matter as much, it would also be a lot easier to assemble a gathering somewhere. But we're going to need a bigger VidCon. Some of the challenges in this world would be things like the fact that there would potentially be some struggles with diseases in wildlife, as diseases would be difficult to quarantine properly, and invasive plants and animals could be taken anywhere. Other than that, just ask someone who vehemently hates globalization and or immigration. What about airports? I mean, why take a 16-hour flight somewhere you can now reach in a couple of hours? Obviously, commercial flights may not be the norm. For example, Belgium today already has no domestic flights. But that doesn't mean that they'll go away. Looking at North America, we see very much the opposite, as it's way easier to spend a 4-hour flight from Los Angeles to Chicago than a 40-hour train ride with Amtrak, but people still ride Amtrak, so some may take faster planes as an alternative. Though if we're talking about Star Trek age, we probably should be talking more about spaceports, if we haven't built ourselves a space elevator yet. Would a true Earth city ever exist? Perhaps, but most likely not within our lifetimes. In the end, it would, at least at first, be more like just our current cities, just so interconnected that one could hop cities to the other side of the world in a few hours on a hyperloop at a modest speed of 1200 kilometers an hour, though even they can still go much faster. The overall goal of a city, though, is to be a compact space to fit everything into one area, without spreading everything everywhere else. So don't think of a fully urbanized Earth. Think more dense, interconnected urban cores surrounded by empty areas. No matter what we predict today though, it could always turn out way differently. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to like and subscribe to learn something new every Sunday. What do you think a city on a planetary scale could look like? Leave your thoughts in the comments below.